just outside Philadelphia near Valley Forge, Pennsylvania. And I was fortunate enough to be in the Great Valley School District. I went to Great Valley Middle School and then Great Valley High School. Growing up, I was very shy. I was painfully shy. Singing was always an outlet for me. Singing was this thing that I would do like in private, in secret. Whenever I felt scared of the world, I would like hum, or whenever I was like afraid of the dark, I would sing. And it was just this, I don't know, it was something that brought me comfort, and it was something that I think subconsciously I thought I would be safe if I was singing. My mom and dad were really hopeful and insistent that we choose an instrument in third grade. And I chose the clarinet and ended up playing for 10 years and ended up being in the high school marching band as well as doing different productions with plays and musicals. And I think that learning at such a young age how to read music and again how to be part of a team and create something beautiful with people was super life-changing and empowering. Cut to fifth grade, there's this opportunity at Charlestown Elementary School to audition for this musical called Steamboatin'. And my mom and dad, they'd heard me singing in the car and, you know, in these what I thought were private moments. They thought, oh, you know, she has a voice, so like, let's encourage her to really go for this. I'll never forget it. I was in this little music room with our music director of the elementary school. Her name was Mrs. Susan Messner. And I walked in and she was behind the piano, she had glasses on and she was playing, and I added this little jazz riff to the song. It was kind of like a lot of moxie. And she's playing the song, we stopped. She just goes, who taught you how to do that? She like lowered her glasses and was like, where'd you learn how to do that? And I was like, I don't know. And it was just this moment where, you know, all the teachers in the elementary school were like, this child doesn't even speak, so how is she singing like this? And Mrs. Messner saw something in me, took a chance. I mean, that was a pivotal moment for me. She took a chance and gave me this role of Steamboat Sal, a talented and lovely gal. I got to wear a big feather in my hair and this big red dress. I truly have her and my parents to thank for being at that crossroads and encouraging me to go down the path that I did. The Great Valley School District has an incredible arts program. I was so blessed to be a part of it. We had some incredible directors. They gave me opportunities that helped me to kind of hone this thing that I was discovering. They gave me the opportunity to be part of a team, to just have a place where I felt like I belonged. Cut to high school, we had this director named Mrs. Lisa Eaton, who is a maverick and who is gifted divinely, honestly, in directing and in understanding the craft of storytelling. And again, she gave me opportunities to sort of discover even more what it is to lead, what it is to create. I'm so thankful to her for seeing me and giving me that chance. I think the moment that I realized that it was going to take a significant amount of work to make this dream come true is really the college audition process. That was a pivotal moment in high school where I said, okay, I love this. I feel alive. I feel called to this, but I also have these other passions. I really wasn't sure if I wanted to give this my all until I did a summer program at Carnegie Mellon University the summer before my senior year. And I think it was, again, one of the greatest gifts my parents have ever given me. It makes me hopeful for the future. So I ended up auditioning for Carnegie Mellon the next year and was so fortunate to be accepted into the program. It was a no-brainer to say yes to that program. I thought, you know what, when I'm 40 years old, I don't want to look back and say, what if? I just knew that Carnegie Mellon had such a bar of excellence and that their training was so solid and that it would call me to my best. When we were finally able to do the main stage productions, we had a guest artist come in, director Mr. Kent Gash, who gave me the opportunity to play Little Red Riding Hood in Stephen Sondheim's Into the Woods. And at that time, I hadn't really explored too much this comedic capability at all, but he gave me this chance to be Little Red and to get into this role. I first auditioned for the role of Glinda in my senior year of college before I graduated. In January, I got a phone call that they'd like me to come play Glinda on the first national tour of Wicked. And forget it, that was the best moment. I'm still speechless. Moved to New York right after college, was in a fringe festival musical called Bunked, a new musical about some camp counselors, kind of a coming of age story, so fun. And then I had the opportunity to do an off-Broadway play called Letter from Algeria at the Abingdon Theater, also in New York City. So at the root, I guess I'm just in love with stories. And so I want to continue doing work on TV, doing work on film, doing work in theater, telling stories. And I think stories bring us together. We access our common humanity. I want to be part of that. I want to be part of people seeing themselves in a character. I want to be part of instilling hope and light and making people laugh and bringing people together. So that's my goal whenever I hop on set or on a stage.